story. Or several different stories. This is the London that I recognize.
But do you recognize the people there?
Why'd you ask that?
Well, you said you had friends at Boyle.
I don't remember much.
Did they ever talk about a band of artists who played strange sounds on things that they made?
That rings a bell. Tell me about them. Frankenstein monsters put together with nuts and bolts and glue. They made no music. It had no meaning. There was no rhythm, no melody,
no harmony, no hits,
no Sergeant Pepper. Now I remember. N-I-H-I-L-I-S-T. N-I-H-I-L-I-S-T.
Everything that London wasn't was exactly what they were.
And London loved them and loathed them, but they refused to disappear. They got invitations to destroy the nations. They took Manhattan, Tokyo, Paris. Six guys are not all in the band, or am I missing something here?
Only the rest of London history, tied into the story,
sucked into the vortex, strolling players on a painted stage.
There's Boyle out there on the left,
some hopeless drifter you might. Hit me.
He looks like he might beat me.
I wouldn't wrestle that arm for my life. Creative spirits from the present and the past, summoned to attend some cosmic conference, standing on the corner where the busker plays in summer.
Moving to
means.
A puzzle for the viewer.
A secret to the picture. Do you want to guess?
No, go on, spill the beans.
You know they once made cars in London long ago. The greatest one was called the London Six.
They could have been an
Detroit's baby brother. They once had it all, the cars, the music too.
General Motors, Chevrolet,
Stevie Wonder, Marvin Gaye.
Detroit has not.
N-I-H-I-L-I-S.